How would you record giving back money to a customer who paid you immediately? In that case, you would make a refund receipt. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. You will record a refund receipt when you are refunding money from a sale receipt, not an invoice. It is the exact same steps as making the original sale receipt. However, it has the opposite effect of the original sale receipt. You must use the same items or income accounts that were on the original sale receipt that is being refunded. In other words, on the original sale receipt, the income went up when you put the item onto the receipt. And then, of course, when they paid you, either cash in bank or undeposited funds went up. That means when you make the refund receipt, of course, cash in bank will go down because you're paying back money, but the original income account that went up for the original sale receipt will go down by the amount of the refund. For example, back on January 18th, we made a sale receipt for Betty for 16 video hours. When we did that, video income went up, and because she paid us directly to the bank account, cash in bank also went up by the same amount. Now, the trial balance you see includes the result of that sale receipt, and these are the numbers we have before we record our first refund receipt. Now let's imagine on March 19th, we refund to Betty only 4 of those 16 hours, and in order to do that, we write her check number 14. Well, when we do that, video income will go down because if we're giving back money for a video job, we earned less video income. And of course, if we're giving back money, cash in bank will also go down. And the amount that both of those accounts will change is $1,200. So that means that after the refund, cash in bank will decrease by $1,200 and become $27,290. Video income will decrease by $1,200 and become $48,000 even. Let's take a look at how to record it in QuickBooks Online. Now here we are in QuickBooks Online with all the numbers in the trial balance before the refund receipt. To record the refund receipt, we click the plus sign, we go all the way over to the column that relates to customers, and we choose Refund Receipt. Now filling this out is exactly the same as filling out the original sale receipt. We choose the proper customer, in this case Betty Boop. Now in our little story, we are recording this refund receipt in March or on March 19 of 2017. Please put the correct year, that's very important. Now down here where it says received from, you can, or refund from actually, you have to choose the account that you're paying from. We're not giving her back petty cash, we're paying the money from a check, which is cash in bank. So it's coming from cash in bank, and we're going to put check number 14. Now, we have to put the product or service that we're refunding, in this case it was video, because the customer was not satisfied with 16 video hours, so we're refunding 4 of those video hours back to customer Betty. And that makes the amount of the refund $1,200 that we pay Betty with check number 14, which reduces video income because we've earned less video income if we're giving back some of the money for a video job. Click Save and New, and successfully issued in the amount of $1,200, that's a good confirmation. Now when we click OK, we can close the receipt window and go back to the trial balance, and you can see cash in bank is exactly the number we expected, $27,290, and video income is exactly as what we expected, $48,000.